In this video, I'm going to show you my 11 most used Ableton keyboard shortcuts so that you can spend less time navigating Ableton and more time creating. Brett Pontecorvo here at livekeyboardist.com, where I help keyboard players just like you with the ins and outs of Ableton, with creating an excellent live setup, and with mastering sound design. If you're new here, please consider hitting that like and subscribe button. Without further ado, let's jump into my 11 most used Ableton keyboard shortcuts. So my first most used keyboard shortcut is really simple. It's just tab. And tab is going to help you switch back and forth between session view and arrangement view. But as you'll notice right now, I have nothing on my screen. So we need to use some keyboard shortcuts to bring some information into our live set. So our second keyboard shortcut is Command Option B. And that's going to show and hide our browser. Now to really quickly navigate our browser, we're going to use the keyboard shortcut Command F. And that's going to bring us into our search bar so that we can quickly pull in a sound. So I love this sound, the Synth U Giant. It's from Ian McIntosh's course. And right now the sound that I want to use is actually already at the top, but if I wanted to navigate, I could do so using my fourth keyboard shortcut, which is the arrows. And the arrows let you really quickly select a sound. And when I want to pull it in, I can just hit enter. And that's going to bring it right into my live set for me. Now, once you have an instrument in your set, you probably are going to want to add a clip to that channel strip. And you can quickly create a MIDI clip using the keyboard shortcut Command-Shift-M. Now, once I've brought this clip in, I can quickly rename it by using the keyboard shortcut Command-R, which will rename it. And I can come up with a good name, maybe Groovin' Line. Hopefully, you can come up with something better than that. And perhaps I'll want to enter in some MIDI notes. And once you've entered in those MIDI notes, you can quickly hide all of those details by using the keyboard shortcut Command Option L. Now, if you want to go back to see your device or whatever you're using to play, you can do that by using the keyboard shortcut Shift Tab. And Shift Tab is a really fast and essential way to move between your device view and your clip view while you're editing. All right, friends, we got three more keyboard shortcuts, so stay with me till the end here. Keyboard shortcut number 9 is Group, Command G. Now, this can come really in handy if you are wanting to have everything in one little container. So right now, I've got this Synth U patch here, and this has already got a lot of stuff in an instrument rack, but perhaps I wanted to add an extra reverb, which using the keyboard shortcuts that we already know, Command Option B, to reveal our browser, Command F to search, and then I can just type in reverb and use the arrows there. And if I hit enter, it's gonna bring it right in. Now, if I wanted to group this, I can use my new keyboard shortcut. If I select everything, Command G. And that's gonna bring it all into one instrument rack, which gives you all sorts of cool features like your macros, your chain selector, and key range. The 10th shortcut can be particularly useful if you're working on editing something that you've played. So I'm gonna play this clip really quickly. And let's say I'm trying to edit it, I might want to pause it, which I can do by hitting space. But if I hit space again, it's going to start all the way at the beginning of the clip, and sometimes we don't want that, especially if the clip is longer. So this 10th keyboard shortcut, Shift Space, will allow us to pick up right where we left off. And finally, our last keyboard shortcut is how we get the music out of Ableton, which is Command Shift R. And Command Shift R will open up our audio export tab. Now on the right-hand side of the screen, I've got two videos here that are gonna help you continue your Ableton growth journey. Now if you want some personal one-on-one time learning Ableton with me, I've got a link in the description below that's gonna allow you to book that time. I am here for you and I would love to be a resource for you. Thank you so much for watching and I will see you next time at Live Keyboardist.